Tara Sharp.
My husband and I attended many Make-A-Wish events and galas. We were lucky enough to attend the Sonoma Couture event, and we raised a lot of money for children who were terminally ill and for whom a special wish was something that was really meaningful. All those years of donating to Make-A-Wish, I never imagined that I myself would someday be a mother of a Make-A-Wish recipient. So I was shocked when 6 years ago, I was 6 months pregnant with our second daughter, and I was shocked when I went in for a routine ultrasound and found out that our daughter was actually missing about half of her heart. The doctors told us that they would need to terminate the pregnancy immediately. And you can imagine just my shock and horror at hearing this news. Fortunately, I called a medical professional friend who called another friend and another friend, and within fewer than 24 hours, we identified a doctor at Stanford Children's Hospital here just locally who could perform the type of surgery that our daughter Ellie would need. So we went through with pregnancy. I went into labor early and had to be helicoptered in the middle of the night from Santa Rosa to Lucille Packard Children's Hospital. But there at Lucille Packard Children's Hospital, our daughter Ellie was born. We were very lucky in that the Children's Hospital was able to intubate her immediately, and at age 5 days, she had her first heart surgery. And then when she was 6 months old, she had another heart surgery. That heart surgery was particularly scary because she only had a 30% chance of survival. I hope that none of you have the experience of being the parent or a grandparent or frankly any loved one and looking at a young child and thinking, this young child has a very slim chance of survival. It was absolutely excruciating. My mom, who's here with me tonight, has experienced this multiple times because not only did our sweet little girl go through this, but as did my mom's two sisters and about 50 other family members. I'm very happy to say that our sweet little girl, Ellie, is the first of 50 family members to actually survive this medical condition. And I'm forever grateful to Dr. Hanley at Lucille Packard Children's Hospital and the absolute miracles that they've performed. Ellie's heart surgery was only pioneered 4 years before she was born. So this was really cutting edge technology, and it's just extraordinary that she's alive today. It's literally a miracle. Now, one of the things that you have to do when you're living in a hospital and there's constant beeping and you're living under extraordinary stress because you don't know if your child's actually going to live, is you lose a sense of reality. You don't know what the weather is like outside. Food all starts to taste the same. And you don't know the difference between day and night because the lights are always on. And so you kind of enter this like time warp, this bubble. And I'm sure many of you have either been in the hospital yourselves or been with a loved one when they're in the hospital. So you know what this experience is like. Well, for us and for little Ellie, what we spent a lot of time talking about was Princess Anna. and Princess Elsa from Frozen. They're the neck down. And you cannot imagine what it means to an infant and a toddler girl to think about something that's total fantasy and reality and unlike anything at all with the extraordinary pain that she's experiencing at that time. And so I remember turning to my husband and saying, my God, success here would be that she survives and someday she's old enough to be naughty and I could actually do something like give her a timeout. Like, that would be so cool. And so she really liked the character in Anna in the movie Frozen, because Anna was always very naughty and always doing very mischievous things. So as it turns out, Anna was this character that Ellie really identified with. And we must have watched that movie 200 times. We had books about Anna, coloring books about Anna. And really, Princess Anna and Princess Elsa helped keep Ellie's little spirit alive and helped her really keep fighting for something that she didn't really even know existed, but I did. And that was a full life. Ellie deserved a full life. And lucky for us, she got it. So we kept her inspired and told her that when she was better, we would take her to Disneyland and she would get to meet her hero. I had no idea at this point that we would be Make-A-Wish recipients, and our doctors were kind enough to nominate us for the Make-A-Wish program. And I'll never forget the Make-A-Wish volunteers coming to our home and asking 3-year-old Ellie, "Now Ellie, what would you like as your wish?" Ellie thinks for a minute. "Well, I'd like a pet dolphin." The Make-A-Wish people and I start looking at each other going, "Oh my God, a pet dolphin." And I said, "Well, Ellie, where would you keep the dolphin?" Oh, and she, apparently 3-year-old Ellie had this all figured out. "Oh, the dolphin's gonna sleep in the pool. And in the daytime, it's gonna come in the house and play with me." Great, okay, well, that's not gonna work out very well. So we said, "Well, Ellie, what's your other wish?" Oh, that's an easy one. "I wanna go meet Princess Anna." "Yes, we can do that. Let's go meet Princess Anna." So thanks to Make-A-Wish, our family, so little Ellie and her big sister Cece, my husband and I, got to go to Disneyland for 3 days. Ellie had a wish pass, which enabled her to go to the front of all the lines, and we spent about an hour with Princess Anna and Princess Elsa, and they were cracking jokes with one another, and if you talk to Ellie today, she will tell you that she is really good friends with Princess Anna. That is the magic of Make-A-Wish. And I'll tell you that my husband and I, as the girls met Princess Anna and Princess Elsa, we stood in the corner and we both just absolutely broke down in tears. To know that this little girl who was so close to losing her life and had to fight so hard and for so long to even survive, the fact that she was able to survive all of that, come back and become friends, become buddies and crack jokes with princess, you know, these princesses, was beyond extraordinary. And the Make-A-Wish focus is really on the children, but in our particular case, the wish was probably as great for my husband and I as it was for our daughter. So I'd like to thank each and every one of you for contributing to Make-A-Wish. Make-A-Wish means more to these children than you could possibly imagine. It means so much more than I ever imagined before I had a child who was terminally ill, and I was in the seats that you're in tonight. So thank you for your generosity. Thank you for helping little Ellie and so many others achieve their wildest dreams. And thank you also, Make-A-Wish, for not delivering a dolphin to my house. I really appreciate that.